Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is a mini collaboration with my friend Aya. The requirements were to use Lanfun stems and to create a foil card, just for fun. So first, let's see what Aya has created. It's a lovely kitchen scene with two cute bunnies baking pies. I love that they're holding spatulas and it looks like they're very impatient to have a slice of pie. I love the jars of jam too, and the sunflower is a perfect transition to my card. I also love Aya's mixed media projects and the deep colors she uses to create them. My favorite is definitely this gorgeous blue canva. Everything coordinates so beautifully. You will find links to Aya's YouTube channel and Instagram page below the video, so make sure to go check her amazing work. So now let's see how I've created my card. I first started by cutting several elements to build the background. A rectangle panel, two wavy borders and a grass border. All from Strathmore Bristol cardstock, my favorite paper when I use these tracings. On the rectangle panel, I created clouds using a homemade stencil and faded jeans distressing. Don't mind the bottom of the panel, it was a first attempt, but I wasn't satisfied with the result. Next, I created texture on the clouds by splattering water drops on the paper, as well as drops of faded jeans. For the larger wavy border, I used peeled paint and forest moss distressings. I started by applying peeled paint all over the border, and then I applied forest moss from the bottom towards the top to create shadows. For the smaller wavy border, I wanted to create a path, so I first applied scattered straw distressing. Next, I applied rusty inch distressing, but it wasn't dark enough to me, so I added ground espresso that I blended using rusty inch and scattered straw. And I used rusty inch and ground espresso to splatter drops on this border, and this way create dirt or sand texture. As always, I stamped my images on Nina Solar Watt cardstock using jet black ink, and I colored them using my spectrum noir markers. When the coloring was done, I assembled a few things. I attached the puppy at the back of the basket using liquid glue. And I stuck the beret to the girl's head. I had to restem the fairy because her arm was in the way, so I masked it using washi tape and stemmed it again. I colored the scarf only. Next, I outlined it to get a consistent design. And then I fussy cut it. And to get rid of all the little black lines, I simply used my white gel pen to cover them. One more thing before moving on to the next step, I used glue dots to attach the girl to the bicycle. To make things easier and prevent the different layers to move, I taped them to my work surface using washi tape, and then I attached the sunflowers on the red cart using glue dots. I placed my images on the background to have an idea of where to add my pull tab element. I marked the top of the sunflower pile using a pencil, and I used my T-ruler to trace two vertical lines, one from the pencil mark and one from the top edge of my panel. On the top edge mark, I taped the notch die. On the bottom mark, I taped the slot die. And I sent them to my die cutting machine. I also needed to cut the slot out of the sky panel, so I simply used the wavy border as a guide to mark the slot spot. I taped the slot die to my background panel and sent it to my die cutting machine as well. And now that both slots are coordinated, I can tape the wavy grass border to the sky background. Next, I die cut the pull tab mechanism. I folded the tabs and I applied tape on those tabs. I put this pull tab mechanism through the slot at the back of my panel. And I also die cut the sleeves that I folded and attached at the back of my panel. This will help the pull tab go up and down straight. Next, I trimmed off the excess of paper and adhered the remaining piece of cloud background at the top of the pull tab. And of course, I added a tiny arrow to the tab so the recipient of the card knows to pull it. Next, I assembled more things. I stuck the grass border down to the brown wavy border using foam tape. The tabs were a little bit too large and were sticking out from behind my scroll, so I simply trimmed them off so I can adhere this little guy. To complete the foreground of my scene, I also attached the girl on her bicycle using glue dots. And next, I stuck this whole element down to my panel using three layers of foam tape. And I attached the trees using glue dots. The khaki green wavy border looked a little bit too flat to me, so I simply took a tiny wave stem from the Ahoy Métis stem set. I turned it upside down and stamped little heels using peel paint distress ink. I always forget to leave a spot for my sentiment, but lucky me, this time the grass border was wide enough to receive this sending warm wishes phrase. I stuck my panel to a craft card base, and finally I added little leaves here and there. And that's it. So what do you think of this card? Would you like to see different versions of it in the next weeks? Don't forget to check out Aya's video. The link is in the description box below the video. Thank you so much for watching and for always being so supportive. Have an amazing day. Bye!